When it comes to body positivity, Khloe Kardashian has really come a long way, and we have a lot to learn from her.
Life experience is just like, you just feel good mentally, physically, everything.
Khloe's motivation to teach people how to love themselves from the inside out for a healthy mind, body, and soul is truly inspiring. She says she's struggled with body image and weight in the past, and is dedicated to help people succeed on their own personal journeys.
My journey is longer than others, but for me, it's a lifestyle.
36-year-old Khloe is the youngest Kardashian sister. Her parents, Robert Kardashian and Kris Jenner, Kardashian at the time, divorced in 1991, and her mom would go on to marry Bruce Jenner, now known as Caitlyn, and have two more children, Kendall and Kylie. The sisters grew up in the spotlight and became household names on Keeping Up with the Kardashians. Khloe is known for being the most outspoken of the Kardashian-Jenner family, and has been using her voice to promote health, love, and body positivity over the years. She's shown us what it means to get mentally and physically healthy, and encourages those around her to follow suit. She doesn't back down from a fight, and this strong mentality is inspiring to everyone watching, who has experienced some of the same negative events and insecurities, to take action and love themselves for who they are. From feeling out of place growing up, to awkward shopping experiences and negative media comments, Khloe has experienced it all and come out on top. Through sharing her story, fans, friends, and followers might be inspired to find their own happiness.
So it's been a slow process because I want it to be a forever process.
Khloe's website, khloewithak.com, looks like it's been taken down, but in 2018 she wrote a blog post that revealed she wasn't very close with her sisters when she was growing up. In the post she said, "I was always the annoying little sister who was desperate to get any attention from them. Both of them looked so similar to one another and my appearance was so different." In a very relatable interview, Khloe told People magazine that she always felt chubby when she was growing up, saying, "My girlfriends were always running around in two pieces, and I never felt comfortable enough to do that." Khloe describes something so many girls and women have felt in their lives. In the same interview, Khloe said, despite it all, she always felt comfortable in her own skin, though she had a different body type than her two older sisters. She praised her parents for always loving and nurturing her, and always making her feel beautiful. When Keeping Up with the Kardashians started, she was thrown into the spotlight. And while she thought she was in good shape, the media started saying mean things about her appearance. In order to cope with the negative comments, Khloe says that she started to take ownership of being the funny sister who looked different. Looking back on that time, she told People magazine, "I wasn't fat. I wasn't obese. It was just society and the media that was making her feel that way." She added that she doesn't believe in numbers and doesn't weigh herself. She's committed to living a healthy lifestyle, eating right, and working out, so that she can be both mentally and physically happy for herself. She said in the interview with People magazine, "It's not about fitting someone else's standards." Khloe has had a life full of very public ups and downs. Her father passed away when she was 19 years old, and she went through a very public divorce from Lamar Odom. In an interview with Health magazine, Khloe said when she was going through her divorce, she really needed an outlet, adding that she had an unhealthy relationship with food, so she joined Equinox and would escape there instead. As a result, she started becoming healthier.
I really enjoyed what I started seeing, so I was like, oh, okay, let me take this a little seriously.
Khloe launched her reality show, Revenge Body, in 2017. The show's description starts off by saying, "Everyone knows what it's like to feel alone, left out, different, or just not good enough. Welcome to Revenge Body, the show that is going to turn lives around with the ultimate true and total makeover of the exterior and interior." The show was on the air for 3 seasons and invited people who had gone through a traumatic experience to become healthier mentally and physically. On each episode, Khloe would interview the guest, going through the transformation process, their backstory, and how they felt once they were done. Khloe revealed on Revenge Body that one of her family members told her she needed to lose weight because she was hurting the family brand. She said while she understood that it was coming from the management side of her family, she admitted that it hurt. But it was just one moment that inspired her to help other people with the same insecurities as her to love themselves. In an Instagram post, the youngest Kardashian sister said, "Once I started started putting myself first, everything else fell into place. My life transformed a few years ago when I made the decision to stop existing and start living. Several publications have published lists of inspiring Khloe Kardashian quotes, and we love this one. The best form of revenge is a good body. I'm not seeking revenge on one particular person, it's revenge on life and being the best me. This quote was taken from an interview with People magazine. Khloe also went on to launch her own clothing line in 2016, Good American. The line carries clothes for women of all shapes and sizes, from 00 to size 24. The line takes pride in being inclusive, and you'll notice that the advertising features diverse women of different races and sizes, and real women were chosen to be featured in her first campaign. The brand promotes looking good and doing good. With every purchase, Good American donates a portion of their profit to Step Up, a nonprofit organization that empowers girls from under-resourced communities through mentorship programs. Khloe has said in interviews before that she would feel shamed by sales associates when she would go shopping with her sisters. She said in an interview with the Evening Standard that sales assistants would say, "We don't carry that size here," making her feel really embarrassed. One of her goals with Good American was to make sure that no woman ever has to feel the way she felt while shopping. She even banned the term plus size from her line.
I don't really believe in the term plus size. I like to just say you modeled.
Yeah.
Khloe spoke at Fortune's Most Powerful Women conference about her clothing line's plus-sized mentality. "I don't want to be called that. I'm a woman with curves." Khloe famously lost over 40 pounds, even though she says she's not counting. In 2015, a comedian on Saturday Night Live poked fun at her weight loss, insinuating that the world had lost a Kardashian that they could relate to. Khloe responded on Twitter with, "No need to tear others down just to make yourself feel bigger. It actually makes you quite small," adding, "I'm on a healthy journey. I don't care for the hate." Khloe owns her decisions and the body she's in, and that is something that we honor and hope that she continues to do as she progresses in her career. In 2018, Khloe gave birth to her daughter True, who she shares with NBA player Tristan Thompson, who she wants to be a positive role model for. While she has an on and off relationship with Tristan, an insider told E! News that Tristan said she's in a great place in her life where she's focused on True and co-parenting with Tristan. A source told Us Weekly that Khloe is super involved in her daughter's life, saying Khloe is very emotionally and healthily supportive as a mom. She is very communicative and always tries to set the best example for True to live by mentally, emotionally, and spiritually. When the COVID-19 pandemic hit earlier this year, Keeping Up with the Kardashians had to stop filming, and the Kardashian-Jenner family resorted to filming their own footage on their phones while they were isolating. In March, we learned that Khloe was diagnosed with COVID-19. Her entire journey was documented on the reality show. Once she recovered, she was vocal about her frustrations at seeing people crowding beaches and not taking the pandemic seriously. Khloe takes her health very seriously, and after recovering from the virus, she used her platform to help others understand the virus. On Keeping Up with the Kardashians, Khloe emphasized that the virus is very real. After recovering, she told Refinery29 that keeping a routine has really helped her stay grounded throughout this tough year. She said, "I definitely think because of my fitness journey and already having such a regimented schedule when it comes to working out, it kind of kept me sane during these crazy times. I had to learn to adapt my mommy-daughter workouts." While Khloe's two-year-old is not working out per se, she is including her in her workout activities, like running up a hill with True in a wagon. While Khloe has many businesses and many callings in life, promoting a healthy lifestyle is one that seems to give her energy. While Keeping Up with the Kardashians is coming to an end in 2021, there is no doubt in our minds that she will continue to spread love and positivity to those in her life and to her fans and followers. One of her most recent Instagram posts offers a quote to help people get through a tough year. "A happy soul is the best shield for a cruel world." Just under half a million people liked the post, which attests to the positive impact Khloe has on her friends and fans. Recently, Khloe took home the People's Choice Award for Reality Star of 2020. This is the third year in a row that she's won the award. After her win, she said on Twitter, "I cannot believe you guys did this. You guys picked me to win a People's Choice Award, and that, I think, means more to me than anything else. I literally have no words. I feel so honored, and I am so appreciative and so grateful. Sometimes I'm like, wait, what? Why? It's just so baffling to me, but I feel really good. I feel blessed. It's clear that people really stand behind Khloe and what she stands for. She taught herself to love herself. We can all learn a thing or two from the reality star. Khloe has a bright future ahead of her, and we hope she keeps inspiring young men and women with her positive energy and message. We'll leave you with this last message from Khloe's Instagram account. Love your curves, ladies. Love your body. Love yourselves. And most importantly, let's continue to empower one another. We love to hear from you. Do you have a favorite Khloe Kardashian moment or a positive message about loving your body to share? Let us know in the comments below. For more videos on the latest in pop culture and beauty trends, subscribe to The Taco. Don't forget to turn on notifications so you don't miss a single video. Bye for now.